Hey, I'm Dionysios from bycompanyname.com, and today I will show you how you can update your basic DNS settings for your name silo domains. Before I start, I would like to ask you to like this video and subscribe to the channel if you enjoy the content. I have divided in three chapters. Chapter 1 is for updating the name servers, Chapter 2 is for adding a record and CNAME, and Chapter 3 for adding a TXT record. But before you can visit the chapter that you want to watch, you need to know where you will find all these details. I have already signed in for my name silo account, and from this section, my account, or here on the top, if I click the face again, my account, I can see the list of the domains that I own. In the next screen, I choose this option on my right, Domain Manager, and I can see all the domains that I own. I will choose the one that I want to update the details. So if I click on the domain, I will see another screen. Okay, here I can change my name servers, and for the rest records, for the A record, CNAME, and TXT record, I need to choose here the update option next to DNS records. But for name servers, I can even change them faster than that. I go back to the domain manager by clicking here. Here is the domain. I have the option change name servers. As you see, these are the standard name servers for NameSilo. But if you want to use another hosting company like Bluehost, SiteGround, or Hostinger, then they will give you some name servers that you want to put there. For my example, I will just put the name servers from dan.com, that is a domain marketplace. And then I go submit, I click submit. It takes up to 48 hours for you to be able to see your details. You can always revert to the original name servers. Click here to select our default name servers, and you can change them. Let's go to the chapter 2 now, when we want to add an A record and CNAME. I choose the same domain. I click on it. Something is happening because I changed the name servers fast. I confused the system. Okay. Now, when you need an A record or CNAME, for example, if you don't want to change your name servers, but you use another hosting company, let's say an example. If you want to establish a Shopify store with a custom domain, you can do it like that. I go to DNS records. I delete everything that I see here. And I will replace them details from Shopify. This is the same process for any other store or hosting company. Okay, I want an A record. I click here. Host name, I leave it empty, and I copy that IP address. Submit. I see that everything is okay. Now I need a CNAME. I click here, CNAME. I will click www, and this is for the target host name. Submit. and the domain will redirect to my Shopify store. But again, this change will require some time. They say up to 48 hours. In my case, the most I have waited is up to one day. Okay, let's go to the chapter 3 now. For the TXT record, again I repeat the process. I choose the domain, I click on it, choose DNS record, update, add the TXT record here, and you need the TXT record when you want to verify the ownership of a domain. For example, when you want to add your domain on the Google Search Console. I will add property here. I will add the domain and Google will provide me some details. I copy that TXT record. I add the TXT record here. I leave it empty. I paste on text. Voila. Again, it will take some time for my domain to get verified by Google, but this is the process. Leave a comment below if the interface has changed, if something is unclear, or you have an idea for a future video. Bye!